É sashimwe.
Amen, amen. Praise God.
Dusuhuze bene data bamaze kugera ku murongo badukurikiye.
Let's greet beloved ones who are already connected and following us.
Rwasuje mu izina rya Yesu.
We greet you all in the name of Jesus.
Bifuriza amahoro y'Imana kubana nawe.
And we wish the peace of the Lord to be with you.
Hallelujah.
Amen, amen.
Dusuhuze bene data turi kumwe kuri uyu munsi.
Let me greet the beloved one that are with me tonight.
Yes, Hashim. Yes, Hashim.
Praise God.
Amaro imana banena.
May the peace of the Lord be with us all.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Tukongeye gushima imana kugera kuno munsi.
We are thanking God who has enabled us to be here this time.
Wagaciro imana yaduhaye isaha yagaciro kumbere y'amaso imana kaba mama n'abakobwa.
It's a privileged moment, an hour that the Lord gave us as mothers and daughters to join together at this time.
Nishema kuba hano kandi nizere ko nawe wahageze Imana mwishuri gumugisha.
It's such a joy for us to be here with you. I believe that whoever is here will be blessed with us.
Mbere kugicyo dukora kaduce bugufi dusenga Imana mbere kugatangira.
And before we carry on with our program, let's humble ourselves and pray to God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We take mana yacu.
Almighty Father.
Data dushimi zina ryawe.
Father, we thank you for your name.
Tugushimiye kuri no mwanya mwiza wongeye kuturonkera mwana.
We thank you for this wonderful moment that you've given us today.
Data nagaciro kenshi kongera kuba imbere y'amaso yawe.
It's such a privilege to be in your presence once again.
Iyo turi hano mwami Imana turatuza turanezerwa.
When we are here, we feel calm and joyful to be with you.
Icyumweru ni kinini mwami Imana yanje.
A week is so long.
Waturinze kama mama hirya no hino n'imiryango.
You've protected us with our families. And we've come again in your presence. Under your feet, under your glory. To come and listen and just hear from you. We are humbled, our Father God. That may you cleanse us whatever in whatever way that law looks and faithful to you. Our thoughts, our mind, our soul, everything within us. May it be cleansed by the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are going to start our talk. And we believe you're with us. Holy Spirit, come and guide us. That whatever we will say here will be according to your will. We refuse anything that is not of you, Father. All the powers of the enemy and the powers of darkness that may interfere with this program. We are destroying them in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, would want to see you this evening. Allow us to be your vessels. Touch our hearts. Speak to whoever is following us. And may your name be glorified today. As we see you and listen to you. And then you will be strengthened in our souls. In the mighty name of Jesus, we've prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Dushimi Imana bene data ba mama bakobwa.
We are thanking God, beloved ones, daughters, and brothers. We are once again in the presence of God. This is where we come and feel joyful and gather peacefully. Because we are in the presence of our Father. And that's where we come and put all our burdens. That's where we come and humble ourselves. That's where we come to hear the voice of the Lord. And may his name be glorified.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I welcome each and everyone that is following us. Mothers and daughters all over the world. Beloved ones that are in Zion Temple Celebration Center. Center or in other churches, leaders, our mothers, beloved ones, and even our family members. We welcome you all and we will pray that the Lord will bless you for being part of us. I believe you're prepared and ready to receive what the Lord has prepared for us today. This is a very unusual day. It has never been there before. And whatever you're going to see today or hear is going to be new to you. Prepare your heart. prepare yourself to receive
ibyiza byo mu ijuru.
The goodness of God.
Ndabiyegereje cyane kubana natwe.
I welcome you very much to be with us.
Imana mujuru komeze kubambugisha.
And the Almighty God continue to bless you.
Niyegereje n'ubundi benda data turi kumwe.
Once again I'm welcoming my friends here next to me.
Nishema ishema gukora muri Imana namwe.
It's a joy to do serve God with you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, wabugisha kubana natwe.
May the Lord bless us for being together.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Ah, nkuko bisanzwe umunsi wa kane.
As usual, today on our Thursday, we have a talk. The theme of our topic today, to stand in the gap. Standing in the gap.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. As mothers and daughters, we came to talk. To give ideas to each other. To understand more and elaborate more on the Word of God. How? What does the Word of God tell us about standing the gaps?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. What is a gap or what is standing in that gap? A gap is a space.
Ahantu Satani ashobora kwinjirira.
Is a space or an area where the enemy can enter from.
Ijambo Satani ashobora gukoresha.
The word that the enemy can use.
Igitekerezo Satani ashobora gukoresha.
The thoughts the enemy can use.
Kugira ngo akubabaze.
So that he can offend you or hurt you, or he can lead you to sin, or to take you out of God's glory. So tonight or today, as mothers and daughters, we've wished to talk about the word or the theme of standing in the gap. Because it has come to our knowledge that in this season, there is a lot of gaps within this generation in our families. The way we always want our families to look or to be is not the way it is. Maybe that's where we'll give the gap to the enemy or the chance to the enemy. So today we are going to share ideas to get to know those channels the enemy is using to attack us. To try to realize the gaps we've left open for the enemy. And even to stand up and see how we can fill those gaps and close them. How we can close those gaps that the enemy is using in our families. The gaps, the space that is between us and our children. The gap or the space that is between the marriage couples. The gaps or the space that is within families. So we're
going
to look together what the Word of God tells us. And even looking for the references from those who have been there before us, how they handled themselves.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Umwe mu bagaragu ba Nabali abwira Abigayeli muka Nabali ati.
Bagezeyo babibwira Dawudi.
When they reached back, they told David.
Dawudi ngo ararakara cyane.
And David was very upset. So as they were talking to King Nabal, so the servants of Abigail overheard what the servants of King David were telling
Nabal.
So one of the servants or the maids of Abigail went and told her what they had heard. And they told him, Mother.
Ingabo cyangwa se abagaragu ba Dawidi baje gusaba umwami ifashanye.
They told her that the servants of David came to ask for help from Nabal.
Bari bakeneye ibiryo n'ibyo kumwa.
They wanted something to eat and drink.
Ariko Nabali yabakankambiye basubizayo nta kintu bahaye.
But Nabal didn't give them anything. They went back empty-handed.
Uyu mugaragu wa Abigayire amubwira ukuntu Dawidi n'ingabo ze bababereye imfura.
And then they reminded Abigail how the servants of David were very good and helpful to them. How they helped them, looked after them, even in their sheep. So the servant told Abigail,
"Ati urabi menye.
You know very well. You've known this, you've heard it, please do something."
Ati nabi menye nabyumvise kuko Daudi yagambiriye kwica Nabali n'abana be bose.
She said, "Now we've known that David is very upset and he's now determined to kill Nabal and all his servants."
Hallelujah.
So now this is where we are coming in to tell you, to talk about how Abigail stood in the gap. This is an issue that had raised now in the family of Nabal and the wife Abigail. When we read the Bible, it tells us how Nabal wasn't a good man. He wasn't very obedient to God. He knew very well that David and his servants looked after him, looked after his sheep, and they never lost anything of his. It's not like he didn't have anything to give to those
servants.
But he didn't have that heart of giving. And then David was very disappointed and upset. When Abigail heard about that, the Bible says that she is a wise woman and who is very good in appearance. Probably Nabal was not looking after her very well. The word of God tells us he was a drunkard. He never obeyed God. Maybe he even used to abuse Abigail. Maybe he wasn't giving her the values she needed. So, and it reached a point that Abigail realized that Nabal would end up, might even end up being killed because of what he did. But Abigail kept being a very, very wise. And she didn't want the husband to be despised or to be put to shame. She never wanted the family to die. So when you read the whole chapter of 1 Samuel 25, you will get the whole story. That she got everything she could around. She got some bread and meat and drinks. And then she put them on the donkey. And then she told the servants that you can take it to David, King David, and I will follow you. So Abigail decided not to reveal this to Nabal. I don't know mothers of this generation how would have handled this. Knowing very well that your husband has done a mistake, that you knowing very well that he's not even a God-fearing person, and you see that he's reached a point that he's going to be in danger or in a way that he may even be able to learn that he's also a human being. But instead you want to keep covering him up for his mistakes. Instead of going around saying, "Oh, he's a very mean guy, he's like this. So you can see she was a very wise woman. So she followed all that she has sent with the donkey to the King David. So when they approached the David's territory and she saw him, she came off her donkey. And then she had to bow down. And she bowed down in front of the king, as she's also a wife of the king. She humbled herself and bowed down in front of King David.
She asked for forgiveness. And she humbled herself. And she said, Almighty God. Almighty God. Any sin that Nabal has committed, count it on me. Have you ever carried your friend's mistake or sin? Have you ever covered your husband's sin?
Abigail ngo aravuga ngo ibyaha byose Nabali yakoze ubimbareho.
And Abigail said, whatever sin or offense King Nabal might have committed, please count it on me.
Ati ngugirireho umugisha, kugirireho umugisha, umbabarire, umbabarire, ubabarire umujyango wacu, ntiwice abana ndese n'umujyango wa Nabali.
Allow me to receive a blessing from you, please, and forgive my family and my servants.
Abigail ntiyaciye bugufi gusa.
Abigail didn't only humble herself or bow down. She even carried all the sins of Nabal and for the whole family. She accepted even the sins of what she didn't even do.
Asaba imbabazi z'ibintatakoze.
She asked for forgiveness of things she didn't even do herself.
Apfuka gap, apfuka icyuho cyari kiri mu muryango
w'iwe. She tried to fill the gap or the space that was between the families. Ibyago
n'urupfu rwari kuba ku mugabo we n'abana be n'umuryango we.
The death and the sadness that was going to come to his family, to her family, it was all stopped because of the action she did. Because of the way she handled herself, the situation of her family changed. David came to appreciate and to thank her. She said, the Almighty God be glorified. And I also thank you for your wisdom. And may your God also be thanked. To have interfered now that I'm not going to kill the family of Nabal. And you've protected my hands to have shedded blood. And glory be to God for you have come. So the king David had to thank her. So he received the offering that Abigail brought to his family. Beloved ones, today we may not talk a lot, but we are going to take time instead to pray for our families.
Ariko ugira icyo wigamo nk'umumama cyangwa se umukobwa mu rugo rwawe cyangwa se mu muryango uturukamo.
But I would wish you to learn something today as a daughter from a family where you come from or as a mother in your own home. So when there comes a problem in your family or when there is a gap that needs to be covered and filled, how do you handle yourself? Do you start going around blaming each other for their offenses or their mistakes? Have you ever humbled yourself and even ask for forgiveness for the sake of your family or friend when you haven't even done it yourself? That's a question between me and you. Let me not talk too much or take a lot of words on myself. Let me give my colleague here also to tell us what she thinks or what she has to say about it.
Yes,
amen. May God bless amen. You. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Urakoze cyane mama, nange ndakomerezaho warugeze.
Thank you so much. I'll also carry on from where you stopped.
Nakunze cyane ukuntu Abigail yabashije guhagarara mu cyuho cy'urugo rwiwe.
I was so challenged of how, and I loved so much how Abigail stood in the gap of his family and
husband. Mama presidente hano yatubwiye ukuntu Abigail yari umunyabwenge.
We've been told how Abigail was a very wise woman.
Icyo nakongeraho Abigail yari afite imbaraga.
One thing I can add on is that Abigail was a very strong woman.
Abigail niyigeza yumva yuko ikibazo cyabaye bagiye kwica umugabo we abe yacika intege avuga ati baratwishe birarangiye n'umugabo mu rugo niwe wabikoze abe yacika intege.
So when Abigail heard the story, she was not discouraged or getting worried and fear, thinking that, oh, this was my husband, now he's the only man in the house, we are going to be finished of what has happened.
Abigail yagize imbaraga.
Instead, she was strengthened.
Amen. Ikindi kintu Abigayeli yagize ubwenge, yagize good negotiation, yashakishije ubwenge ukuntu ari bujye kuganiriza umwami.
So Abigail also had the wisdom, or she had a good thought of negotiation, how to go and deal with the situation.
Niyegeze agize umugabo inama ati, mugabo wanjye ndabigenza gute, ahubwo iwe yatekereje nk'umugore w'umunyabwenge agira good negotiation z'ukuntu arateka ajyana ibiryo abishira ku mwami Dawidi umugabo we atabizi.
I'm so challenged of the way she handled it. Instead of going to speak to the husband, why have you done this, what has happened, instead she cooked and packed everything to go and cover the gap.
Amen. Abigail cyane twigisha nk'abamama kugira ubwenge mu gihe habaye gap ihari, ukagira ubwenge nk'umumama, kandi ubwenge se tubukurahe? Ubwenge buva ku Mana, tugasenga.
Abigail has taught us here how to fill the gaps as mothers when we see situation coming our way, to see how we can fill the gaps with the wisdom of God, which is the only way forward to seek the wisdom from God.
Amen. Hari gihe nk'abamama tubona ikibazo kije tukavuga ati dufite abatware mu rugo, nibyabatware twe tukumva yuko tugendera ku bitekerezo byabo mudo batubwiye.
We are challenged here and we are learning as mothers or as parents that sometimes when situation come, we don't have to only think, oh, it's up to him, he's a husband, he's the one to resolve it.
Amen. Abigail yabashije kugira ubwenge mu gihe bari bafite icyo kibazo.
So she managed to have the wisdom when a problem was encountered in her marriage or in her family.
Amen. Icyo twasaba ubwenge Imana mu gihe habayeho gap mu rugo rwacu.
All we can require for now from God is wisdom when we encounter problems in our families.
Amen. Tukabasha kugira na good communication mu gihe tugiye kuki.
And also to be able to know how to communicate when a situation arises.
Amen. Urakoze cyane mama.
Arakoze mwene data. Kandi dusabe Meya dusomere muri Esther 4:15 kugeza kuri 17.
Let's look in the book of Esther chapter 15. Esther chapter 4.
Amen.
Let's read the book of Esther chapter 4 verse 15.
Amen. Dusome muri Esther 4:15. Haravuga ngo nuko Esteri atuma kuri Moridekayi aramusubiza ati, genda uteranye Abayuda bari ishushani bose, mwiyirize ubusa munsabire, mumare iminsi itatu ku manywa na ninjoro mutagira icyo mujya cyangwa munwa, nanjye n'abagaragu banjye tuzabigenza dutyo. Uko niko nzasanga umwami nirengagije itegeko, kandi niba nzarimbuka nzarimbuke. Moridekayi ahera karagenda abigenza uko Esteri yamutegetse. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Let's read the book of Esther chapter 4 verse 15-17. Then Esther told them to reply to Moridekayi, go gather all the Jews who are present in the Shushan and fast for me, neither eat or drink for three days, night or day. My maids and I will fast likewise. So I will go to the king, which is against the law, and if I perish, I perish. So Moridekayi went his way and did according to all that Esther commanded him.
Hallelujah. Bamama n'abakobwa nizera ko tukiri kumwe nabaje nyuma tukomeza kubiyegereza.
Mothers and daughters, I'm sure we are still together and we are keeping on welcoming those who are coming also to join us.
Yitwa ngo guhagarara mu cyuho.
We are still in talking about the topic of how to stand in the gap as mothers and daughters.
Turimo turarebera hamwe duhana inama twumva ijambo ry'Imana kitubwira nk'abamama n'abakobwa ibyo tugomba guhagarara mu cyuho mu miryango yacu.
So we are also looking together as mothers and daughters how we can stand in the gap of our families.
Tumaze kureba inkuru ya Abigail.
So we've seen a story of Abigail.
Dusomye n'ubundi ijambo ry'Imana inkuru ya Esther.
We've also now read about Esther.
Iyi ni inkuru mu gihe Hamani yashaka kwica ubwoko bw'Abayuda.
This is the story when Haman wanted to kill all the Jews.
Murayizi neza cyane.
We all know about this.
Haman yari umukuru w'ingabo.
Haman was the king.
Mordekai nawe ni se wabo wa Esther yakoraga kwirembo y'umwami.
And Mordecai was also at the king's gate.
Bigerigihe Hamani azamurwa cyangwa se ahabwa iranka inkuru ndende kuruta abandi.
And it reached a point that Haman was promoted and became a king.
Abo bakoranaga bose barapfukama baramuramya.
So when he was promoted, the everyone that was working with him started worshiping him and bowing down for him. But among those who were bowing for him, Mordecai never did it. The fellow workmates, those who worked with Mordecai in the king's palace, were asking Mordecai, why don't you obey and bow down to Haman as we do? He told them, me, I'm a Jew, I don't do as you do.
Ino jambo naritekerero ndatangara ukuntu turi mu kuviyo twavuye twagera aho tugeze tugasa nabaho tugakora nk'izaho turi natangaye mu rudaka ikuntu yarakora ibwami yarangiza kanga kubaha itegeko ngo nuko ari umuyuda.
This word challenged me how we come and just try to follow the culture of wherever we go, but Mordecai challenged me when he stood by the rules of his Jews, whatever culture. So the news reached to Haman how Mordecai doesn't want to bow down for him. And Haman was very upset, and he started planning to kill him. And he felt it's not enough to kill Mordecai on his own, but I would kill him with all the Jews and all his family. So Haman started plotting how to kill them, even trying to reach the king to convince him.
Ageze ubwo agera ku mwami yemeza umwami ko agomba gusinya itegeko ku buno bwoko butubaha butumvira amategeko y'umwami bugomba kuvaho.
So he managed to reach the king and convinced him to write a new law that says that these people are so disobedient and they shouldn't live anymore.
Haman ntiyagiterekeho gusa yagiye yateye intambwe yemeza gutanga n'amafaranga kugira ngo buno bwoko burimbuke bwose hamwe na Mordecai.
So Haman never stopped to the king writing the law only, but he tried to also put in a lot of money to make sure the whole tribe of the Jews are killed.
Abwira umwami ati jewe niteguye gushira amafaranga mu bigega kugira ngo buno bwoko buveho butakumvira butubaha ibyo uzuvuga.
He managed to convince the king and told him, me, I'm ready to put more money in store to make sure that this tribe that doesn't respect you, doesn't go according to your rules, to be destroyed. And he even told him, these are foreigners who are not even of this country, they are coming from somewhere else. So the king was very convinced and was very upset of how people who come in their foreign land start disobeying him.
Hallelujah.
So the king was very convinced. He said, you don't have to give me your money. Just go and do whatever you want to them. Make the Lord help us.
Hamani ababonye imbaraga, Hamani ababonye inzandiko, ibyemezo bimwemerera kumara Mordecai n'ubwoko bwose.
So Haman was now given the power and authority. He was given even the letters that was allowing him to go and destroy the whole tribe of Jews.
Mordecai inkuru mugeraho.
So the news reached Mordecai.
Mordecai waragenda yiyambura imyenda yose yambira kibigunira ngo yitere mukungugu araboroga.
So Mordecai was very, very saddened with the story. He removed all his clothes, he put on sacks and put on himself in the dust and was screaming and crying to God.
Waragenda yicara ku irembo ry'umwami ngo avuze induru araboroga aravuga ati ibimbayeho ararira cyane aboroga atakira ubwoko bwa.
So he went and sat at the gate of the king, crying and screaming to God. So the story and the news reached Esther.
Esther abyumvishe bimutera bimutera guhagarara ku mutima atuma abagaragu biwe ati mujane imyenda mushyize Mordekai yambare gute ya akoze isoni akambara ibigunira akitera ivu imbere y'abantu.
And then Esther was so disturbed with the actions of his uncle Mordecai. He took his servant, she told the servants to take clothes and make sure he dresses up.
Mordecai abibonye ibyo bamubwiye ibyo bamuhaye abwira atekereza iguru abagaragu ba Esther arabwira ati ni uko byagenze Hamani afite umugambi wo kutwica ndetse n'ubwoko bwacu bwose tugende ubwire Esther ubwire icyo akora.
So when the servants of Esther came to Mordecai to give him what to put on and to tell him to stop what he was doing, he told them to go and tell Esther the whole story of what Haman was planning to do to them. So this is where I want us to talk now.
Esther amaze kumva ino kuru.
So when Esther heard that story,
muribuka ko yatanze imyenda atazi byabaye kuri Mordecai ikintu yambaye ubusa kitera ivu.
Remember, he didn't know why Mordecai was reacting the way he
was.
Now she knew there was a gap.
Ikibazo cyaje mu bwoko bwa.
She knew that now a problem has arisen, has been encountered in his tribe.
Mubagambani wa mubari bufenda wari.
In the people who were meant to die, she was also one of them.
Esther aravuga ati ndabigenza.
And then Esther was wondering what she's going to do.
Mordecai aramubwira ati yamutumaho intumwa aramubwira ati ugomba kugira icyo ukora hari impamvu yakujyanye ari impamvu wisanze uri umwamikazi wenda nicyo cyatumye Imana igushyira kuri ubwo bwami.
So Mordecai said to Esther, you have to do something. Who knows if that's the reason why God has allowed you to be in that king's place?
Atukore ibishoboka byose ugende ku mwami umubwire ibyo Hamani hategura urebe ko warengera ubwoko bwacyo.
So he told Esther, do whatever you can to reach the king and tell him rather what Haman is planning on our tribe.
Esther ngo abura amahoro kubera ko yarazi itegeko ryari rihari.
So Esther was very disturbed. She didn't know what to do because she knew about the laws. She had spent 30 days without seeing the king. So and to reach the king, you need to have a permit or an invitation from the king himself. So the law was that if you go to the king without him inviting you, you would be killed unless the king points his stick on you.
Aya makuru yose yabwira intumwa ya Mordekai cyangwa se umujakazi umuja wiwe amutuma kuri Mordekai akumubwira ati ndabifuza ndashaka kugira icyo nkora ariko itegeko ntirinyemerera umwami ntiyansabye ndabigenza.
So Esther sent that message to Mordecai saying that I would wish to do so, but this is what the law says to me. What do you want me to do?
Ariko Mordecai aramubwira ati nutagira icyo ukora Imana irakoresha abandi bantu ariko wewe nunaso n'umuryango wawe mwese murapfa.
Then Mordecai sent back a message to Esther that if you don't do anything, I know the Lord will do something and rescue us, but you and your whole family will have to be destroyed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Esther amaze kubyumva.
After Esther heard this,
agira courage.
She had the courage.
Atekereza icyo gukora.
She started thinking of what to do.
Agira hasanga yishyira mu mwanya w'ubwoko bwa.
And she started imagining if she was the one in that position.
Areba ukuntu nawe yari umwe muri bo yagiriwe amahirwe kwisanga hari.
So she realized how she was one of them and she was privileged to be where she was.
Aravuga ati atuma wa mugaragu ati genda ubwire Mordecai.
And she sent the servants back to Mordecai.
Ihano twasomye ati bagende babwire abayuda bose batwishushanye.
And that's where we read here now that to tell all the Jews that live in Shushan to go and fast for 3 days and nights without eating and drinking. And I myself and my servants will do it. So when I was thinking about this, I was so amazed. These maids of Esther, they weren't connected to the Jews.
Ariko Esther yabashize muri fasting cyangwa se mu kwiriza kw'imista batajya batamwa.
But Esther put them in that program of 3 days of praying and fasting.
Hallelujah. Baragenda iyo misi itatu irashira barasenga, Esther ngo ahitamo kuja kugenda ku mwami.
So they prayed for the 3 days, praying and fasting, and Esther decided to go to the king.
Tuzi nkuru ko yagenze cyangwa se ko yarangije Mordekai cyangwa sorry Esther yagize favor cyangwa se gikundiro ku mwami ntiyamwica aramwemerera avuga icyo yashakaga.
So we all know how what happened. Esther was favored, the king accepted her to come in and never killed her.
Kangahe ubona ikibazo ugatinya ukaburi cyukora ukareba kwitegeka ukareba kuri system ukavuga ngo iki sinchemerewe kubera system kubera kino gihugu kivuga gutya uga stepping
back. How many times do you see a gap that you need to feed, but you're like, oh my God, I'm not allowed to do this. I'm not accepted to do this.
Arwo arakora ikintu bivuze ko uritanze kugezaho wenda burisika ubuzingo bwa ubwingo bwawe cyangwa se ubuzima bwa gupfa kugira ngo ukize cyangwa tabare undi muntu.
Have you ever reached a point of doing something saying that if I die, I die, but for the sake of rescuing someone else?
Mu gihe cyakera ngo bubakaga imidugudu cyangwa se amazungu bagashiraho wall cyangwa se inkike fence.
So them days they used to build homes and they fenced them with long fences.
Ngombuge habonekaga icyuho cyangwa se gape aho umwanzi ashobora kwinjirira.
Whenever they would see a gap where an enemy can enter from,
iyo woro cyangwa se icyo iyo fence yabizengurukaga uwo mudugudu kwagira ngo abanzi batinjira ngo babatere babarimbure.
So basically the fences they would build on their home, it was to make sure the enemy or the intruders don't come inside.
Mugihe habaga ko kantu iyo gape cyangwa se icyo hagati iyo
whenever they would see a gap or even something breaking the gates,
bashakaga abantu bagomba guhagara hajya muri cyacuho.
They would make people to come and stand in those gaps.
Kugira ngo umwanzi nashaka kuza kubatera.
So that even the enemy wants to come in to attack,
biteguye kumugwanya no kumusubiza.
They would be ready to stand there and refuse him or attack him.
Twabonye Esteri.
We've seen Esther.
Ukuntu yahagaze mu cyuho cy'ubwoko bwawe.
How she stood in the gap of
her tribe.
To be honest, if she hadn't gone to the king or to do something,
Mordekai n'ubwoko bwawe bose babwararimbutse.
Mordekai and the whole tribe of Jews would have been destroyed. But because she surrendered her own life,
selfish,
she wasn't selfish to say, oh, I'm sorry, the Lord doesn't accept me. If you die, people, you can die. She accepted to go beyond the rules of the king. To see if there's something the Lord can do to protect her tribe. And indeed, God did it. Mothers and daughters, we have loads of gaps and spaces. We have children that are failing us, very disobedient. We have families, friends, and couples that are divorcing day by day. If you still have your marriage or seeing your children still good and obeying to you, it's not because you're wise enough. It's not because there's something you've done that is extraordinary from what other families have done. Don't go and sleep and be comfortable thinking the enemy who attacked the other homes will not attack
yours.
Don't wait to go into the process of divorce or to see your children failing and walking, drugs on the streets, and then you start praying. This time, this hour that the word of God has come to you and me, start praying and stand in the gaps. How can we stand in the gaps of our families and our children?
Is
to take time and pray even when our children are at school and fill those gaps. Pray for our husbands or our wives and the children when they're in school, so that the God will help us and build our families to glorify Him. The word of God says that if God is not the one who builds, those who are building in vain.
Yohana 10:10,
John 10:10
bitubwira icyo Satani aza gukora.
It tells us how what Satan comes to.
Unakindi kimuzana.
There's nothing else that brings him
usibye kwica,
only to kill,
kwiba,
to steal,
no kurimbura,
and to destroy.
Ngira ngo murabizi neza kuko ahagaze.
I'm sure you all know that Satan is always alert. But looking around the children of our children, who he can take. Looking for those families he can destroy and create divorces. Don't allow the enemy to put you to shame. Do you allow the enemy to destroy your marriage? Or you're going to decide and stand up and be awake and get to know all the tricks and all the channels the enemy is using and try to find out which gap, which space the enemy can use to enter into your marriage or your family. And then try and stand there in prayer and refuse it and destroy it and defuse the enemy to destroy your marriage or your family. Until he runs away and the glory of God will come back in your home. I took a
Amen.
Lot of words.
Yes, I
oh, yeah, duse wabivuze icyo nakongeraho kuri Esteri ukuntu Esteri yatoranijwe kuko niwe hari impamvu Esteri atoranwa kuba umwamikazi.
The one thing I can add on is that there was a reason why Esther was chosen to be the wife of
Mama namwe hari impamvu muri mu rugo rugo.
So mothers also, all our daughters, yeah, there is a reason why you're in that home.
Hari impamvu ari wewe wubatse muri urugo rugo.
There is a reason why you are the one in that marriage, why you are the husband there or the wife.
Nukugira ngo uhishuguho ruhari.
It's for you, your calling in that marriage is to fill the gaps.
Umenye ko hari impamvu.
So get
to
know. Uri
hariya kugwa impanuka.
You're not in that marriage by mistake. You're there to fill the gap in that marriage.
Nuko Esther yatoranijwe kuba umwamikazi hari impamvu nukugira ngo ngaba.
So as Esther was also chosen to be the wife of the king, we can see that she was chosen because she was meant to be to fill the gap of the Jews.
Amen. Now we had impamvu
uraho. There is also a reason why you're
Amen.
Here.
Yeah. Amen. Hallelujah. Avuza kantu keza cyane.
She said a wonderful word.
Hari impamvu wubakanye n'uwo mugabo.
There is a reason you're married to that husband.
Hari impamvu uri mama w'abo bana.
There is a reason you're a mother to those children.
Hari impamvu wisanze muri uwo muryango.
There is a reason you found yourself when in that family. Maybe you're there to be the light of that family.
Urashaka kuba wubakanye n'umutware wendo utaramenye Imana.
Maybe you married and you don't know you're not yet, you haven't received Jesus as your savior.
Wasangimana aragushiza ngo kugira ngo umurikire wa muntu uzamugeze kuri Kristo.
Maybe you're there so that you may be the light to your husband to accept Jesus Christ.
Wasangimana aragushiza ari kugira ngo wihangane umubere urugero nawe amenye Imana.
Maybe God has put you there so that you may develop your patience and then he will see God in you.
Wasanguraho ngaho kugira ngo umwihanganire umukunde abone Imana bikunyuzemo.
Maybe you're there so that you be patient enough and have more love for him and then he will see the love of God through you.
Hari impamvu Imana yaguhaye abo bana.
There's a reason God has given you those children.
Nishingano zawo kubigisha ijambo ry'Imana.
It's your responsibility to teach them the word of God.
Nishingano zawo kubapfukamira kwabasengera.
It's your responsibility to fill those gaps and kneel down and pray for the children.
Nubone batumvira ngo umve ko ari bisanzwe uvuge ngo ni
igihe tugezemo ni disobedient. If they're disobedient, don't say, oh, this is a normal thing, it's happening with all the generation and think it's a normal thing. Let it give you sleepless nights for you to kneel down and pray for them. Until you chase away those powers from your children and from your family. This is the time to bring our family, our children back to God. So that our families can be built by God. It's only God who connected you to that man and has given you those children. And he's the one with the power to strengthen our marriage and to keep us together. It's not wisdom or some tricks, some play we do alone to make our marriages work. It's just the Holy Spirit or the wisdom of God that helps
resources to know how to handle it.
Rafite reference ijambo
ry'Imana. We have our reference in the word of God.
Mbere imiryango yari ifite wall cyangwa se yari kingirijwe n'ikina value cyangwa se indanga gaciro za Bibiliya z'abakristo z'ijambo ry'Imana.
We've learned that before, the families or our homes were always surrounded, or they were covered by the walls they used to build around them to protect them from the enemies. So those valleys are not there anymore. There is no word of God that is there in our homes. So without wasting much of your time, we know time has we've taken your time. Mother and daughter, let me ask you that we may humble ourselves and use the remaining time to pray. And ask our God to give us the power to stand in the gaps. So we give back to God our families and our children. The God who gives us power of making our homes stand. That to glorify God. I hope the word of God has reminded you something, has woke you up, and is putting you in another position. So that you know the gap in your families, in your children, and how you can stand in it and fill those gaps. If it is possible, wherever you are, let's kneel down and pray to God to give us the power and the strength to stand and fill those gaps and close them.
Let's
kneel down and pray to God. This topic was so beautiful that we felt like carrying on.
But
because of time, let's stop here. It's touching all of us. Personally, I was touched. I don't feel like stopping. That's why we need each other's prayers and to strengthen us and bring our families together to God and say, God, here we are.
Yes,
may God bless you as we humble ourselves and pray.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Those who can, please, let's kneel down and humble ourselves and pray to God.
Yes,
may God bless you as we kneel down and pray together. Our God, Father in heaven, God who created heaven and earth, we are humbling ourselves here in your presence. We've heard lots of words from you. Your word that is waking us up. Your word that is showing us the ways the enemy is using to destroy our marriages and even our children. Father, we are humbling ourselves at this right time.
So
give us where we gave the enemy the chance to intervene and enter. Instead of knowing that these are the gaps the enemy is using, we kept pointing fingers and blaming each other. Instead of knowing that the enemy that has attacked us and his work is to kill and destroy, instead we were very distracted and forgetful of what is happening. We thank you for your word that has reminded us. So we are standing in the power of your word that gives us the power to stop and destroy all the powers of darkness that is attacking our children, our husbands, and even our relatives. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, this mighty hour, if through to any mother or any daughter that is following us, or whoever will take time to follow this talk, I pray that you give our hearts the spirit of obedience. Give us the power to stand in the gaps. Father, give us the power to fill and cover all those gaps.
Let's not just keep looking on the enemy. Let's not allow him. Let's not give him the power. Instead, we stand by faith. By the power of the Holy Spirit.
Oh,
to stand in the gaps and glorifying our families with you, Father. To have time to pray and fast. To get time to pray for our families. To get time, Father, to come and surrender all our families to you.
Oh,
to have time to talk to our children, even to our husbands. That's what your word tells us. That we teach our children the ways they will go, and when they grow, they will never forget about it. I pray, Father, and I would wish that the word that is filled in our hearts, we may be able to display it to our children and our husbands. I wish, Father, would give us that zeal and to always keep praying for the destroying, the families that are being destroyed. I wish, Father, we may be able to be revealed of the powers that are attacking the marriages of today. I wish everyone would have the wisdom of knowing who is attacking our marriages. Father, we are humbled in your presence. That you bring back our children. Bring back our husbands. Our families entirely, Father. To come back and be the one to rule us. May that pleases you be able to happen in our marriages and our families. Father, help us and take away all the shame from our marriages and families. And give us the power to stand. And to stand in the gaps and even to fight against the enemy. We know we cannot do it on our own. By the power of the Holy Spirit that is within us, we know we will be able to do it. And that's what your word tells us. That we can do all through Christ who strengthens us. Allow us to stand and as mothers and daughters, so that we may be able to know how to stand in the gaps. To know when to apply the words. To know how to humble ourselves. Not to use our own carnal wisdom. So that our marriages will not be destroyed. So that our children will not just go anyhow. We bring back all those that the enemy is taking away from us. All the marriages that the enemy is trying to destroy. To try to show them how they should handle themselves and how they should talk. Father, tonight we bring them back to your hands. Father, we show you everything. We give you our hearts. We surrender our families to you. May you glorify yourself. Give us the strength to stand in the gaps. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Thank you, mighty Father.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God, and praise be to you, God. Amen. Thank you, mothers. I'm sure you've been strengthened. And you're going to stand in the gaps of your families. Don't allow the enemy to enter anymore. And don't allow anyone to steal or to kill your marriage. Know your responsibility. Know your goals and your responsibilities as a mother.
Yes,
may God bless you. Have be blessed.
Amen.